You know, this is our first time to be coming back with a live concert here in the church because we're, as you know, for a period of time we were unable to do so because of the pandemic. So we're happy to be back, and on the first Sunday that the choir came back, they sang this piece that we made our own lyrics to, and this is how we got through the pandemic. And this gives you an opportunity to sing at the end by singing that wonderful piece from Latasha Foley, The Best of Times. So when we get to that, it's up to you to join us in singing, okay? You think you can do that?
Yes!
Do you think you can do that?
Yes!
Now, just looking out here, I say it's a very, very smart crowd. And to prove it, I'm going to ask you with your right leg to turn it in counterclockwise. Can you do that while you're sitting there? Lift your right leg and turn it counterclockwise. And at the same time with this hand, make the low number six. That's what I thought.
personal trainer is here. I've been working with her for almost a year, and I have lost 1 pound. Very proud of it. And today, my friend said, you can get on that horse. I did with confidence. The horse in front of me started moving faster, so my horse started moving faster. I thought, well, this isn't going to be too much fun, is it? And I looked behind me, there's another horse coming. And to my right, another horse. And over here, a ravine. And as the thing sped up and we were going, I said, oh my goodness, I'm going to have a panic attack, I know it. I could feel myself about to scream at that very moment. The manager of the Kmart came out and untied me. So I'm very grateful for that. City of New York, we have some our friends from New York here today. Jess is here, professional musician, a wonderful pianist. Phil Delapena, you guys have to get to know each other. Phil, my muse, my wonderful guy, whose piano playing took me from Route 3 right into Martha's Vineyard, and we became instant friends. I walked in there about 4 o'clock in the morning. I said to the maitre d', is that live piano? He said, yeah. I said, my God, where is it? He said, it's in there, first of all. And his friends, of course, Wendy and Mari, others that are here. So that was on the way to and from New York City. So now I'm going to take you from New Jersey to New York City. This is just a simple medley of things about the city, downtown, uptown, east side, west side. Now it's easy to say medley, but I prefer the word pesky. So have some fun with it. We'll see what happens.
Thank you.
given all of us, the gift of imagination. Have you ever stopped to think about that? That it's a gift. Every person here has an imagination. And if you couple it with the divine energy, imagine how much more beautiful the world is. We look around here, stained glass. Who created it? How does somebody know? We look at the beautiful wood, the carvings. How do people understand how to express in this way? To create an instrument like this, digital wiring, to create a sound that's almost like a real pipe organ. And to be given a gift to express God's presence. Many of the Broadway show tunes do the same thing. You know, getting to know you, forsake not yourselves on Sunday, gather together. Your imagination is a bright golden haze on the meadow. Wasn't there one this morning? The corn is high as an elephant's tongue. And then one piece that's in here is, it's from The King and I, and it's from South Pacific, and it's There's Nothing Like a Day. And the reason I'm playing that is because many years ago at Radio City, Wellesley College came. And it was a college for women, and everybody was very excited when the guest speaker spoke. She spoke and spoke and spoke and spoke and spoke, like what I'm doing right now. When she finished 25 minutes, she said, and in conclusion, it's my great pleasure to give Wellesley College a check in the amount of $25 million. And the stage manager looked at me and said, get out to the organ and play There's Nothing Like a Day. Well, tonight we have a day. It's more than that. Much more. 35 years ago, Karen Vick stood right here on first row, hired Fran Duffy to come and play our Christmas program over in Bloomfield in our orchestra. And I found her some years later in the basement of Radio City. She said, I know you. And I said, really? She said, I played this by Christmas in Bloomfield. I said, you did. She didn't play the harp. And she's a magnificent harpist. You can see from her credentials. She's gone wide and far. And she's a marvelous, marvelous friend. Would you warmly welcome Fran Duffy.
Is that it? Oh, we're still.
No, there's like 45 more to go.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I went away to college. I was gone for at least a decade and came back and started playing at Radio City. I think it was 2008 was my first year. I was a sub there. And every year we have to audition. Don't ask me why. Everybody asks. I don't know. It's just the way it is. So every year I audition, and some years I get it, and some years I don't. And I learned the hard way to always use the same piece. I used to try and think of, oh, what will the conductor think? The conductor for a while was somebody I'd worked with at the Fantastics. So, oh, I'll pick a song from the Fantastics. He'll know it's me, and he'll want me. Wrong. So after a while, I just said, you know what? I'm going to play something I love, and that should help. And sure enough, I got the job. And then I decided, you know what? I hear the same pieces every year from the percussionists. And they always get the job. The same people always get it. So I'm just going to play the same piece every year. No more of this trying to figure out and trying to think of something new. So 2019, I get the job again, then COVID. Then last year, I played the same piece again. New music director, didn't get the job. Didn't even get to go in because they shut the show down before my first show. So I was supposed to go in the Sunday after they shut it down on Thursday. So one more time, I go in there, I'm going to play the same piece. So I'm driving down 48th Street, I'm going to park my car, and walk over to the theater, to the Radio City. And some guy's walking across the street, and he's pointing at the front of my car, and I'm like, what, did I hit a cat? I don't know what it is. No, there's smoke coming out of the bottom of your car. So he comes over and he's like, there's smoke and there's something dripping. And I think, oh no, I just had this in at the dealer. Never go to the dealer again. And I pull the car over and the guy happens to be a mechanic and he's, oh, well, let me take a look. And you got to run over it. It looks like coolant. Look, your coolant's low. It's dripping at the bottom. I run over to the hardware store. I'm like, I got to get to Radio City. I got to get to Radio City. I'm going to miss my audition time. So after all this stuff, I'm like running, found a place to park, running to the hall, running in, played last, totally discombobulated by the whole thing, and got the job. So I figured I would share with you my audition piece for Radio City, which is La Source, which is called The Brook, which is the brook in English. And it's a concert etude. It's, you know, you've heard the Nutcracker every year, and it's all this downward arpeggio stuff on the harp. That's what we do best. And so we have to be able to do it well. So Alphonse Hasselmans taught at the Paris Conservatory around the turn of the 20th century, 19th into the 20th, was actually the teacher of my teacher's teacher. Right? Teacher of my teacher's teacher. Yeah, so all my teachers studied with Marcel Grangini, and Marcel Grangini studied at the Paris Conservatory in the late 1800s with with Alphonse Hasselmans. And then he came to the United States and taught at Juilliard for forever, till 1975, 1938 to 1975. And so all of my teachers studied with him, and so I think of Hasselmans as my great-grand teacher, because we all come from this lineage at the Paris Conservatory. This instrument was really perfected in France in 1834, and it really hasn't changed much since then, even the gold and all the pretty. So, which doesn't help the sound, that's another question you don't have to ask later, because it really doesn't help the sound. It just looks pretty. It really does. So this is La Source. It's a concert etude, and you're supposed to hear, as I play, the water flowing down the side of the hill, and sometimes it gets faster and sometimes it slows down, and it's just supposed to be a relaxing kind of, like you're sitting outside near a fountain or near the ocean or near the lake and you hear just water. So this is the most classical we will get tonight. So I hope you enjoy it. This is La Source. Thank you. mention that we're only supposed to play for 2 minutes. So if they let me get to the end, I know I'm good.
You didn't say running water one more time. So on Broadway now we have a music man. Everybody loves the music man. So three pieces tonight, simple. And I think the reason we love the musical Rodgers and Hammerstein is because it's so intuitive. The musical notes follow the language. Let's take a simple Christmas carol. Joy to the world, the Lord is come, from heaven to earth. Our response, let earth receive her King. You see that symmetry? Well, the same is true in this piece, the first one. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana. And I've never been there, but I like the piece. And then after that, till there was you, there were bells on a hill, and I never heard the rain. In my case, it's because I'm deaf. I am writing a book. Is it tinnitus or the teacup? About that for a second. The ringing, you know, which is crazy. It's from playing the organ all these years, but without protection. You know, you need protection. I mean, you're protected. A church crowd on a Saturday night. All right, so here's some stuff from the music man, and perhaps a surprise. How's that?
Yay.
Thank you.
She didn't have enough money for a dancing frass. She couldn't go in a dirty dag, so she just capped down and scribed. Then her Gary Fodmother appeared. And she looked just like Gary. And she waved her magic wand. No, sir, it isn't the bandana. And suddenly a huge coach appeared with Hicks White sorcerer to take her off to the ball. But there was a warning. Render Seller, you be in by midnight or I will turn you into a tumpkin. She left for the ball. She met the Prince of Hicks. And dancing, they lulled in fog. When Rindercella heard the big clock strike right, she turned, she staced down the rails. When she got to the stout and blep, she slopped her dripper. The next day, the Prance and Hints went all over the corn country to find the beautiful girl who had slopped her dripper. Marilyn, when he got to the Mugly Others, place, it fitted it. And then when he tried it on the Sad Lesters, it fitted it. But when he tried it on Rindercella, it fitted it. And it was exactly the sight rise. So then we're Mappily Harry. Now the moral of this story is, if you want a lull and fog, with a prance and hints at a bansy fall, don't forget to slop your dripper.
Now, I'm supposed to have a... Jack, where is he? He's around here somewhere. Oh, God. Hello? Yes? So where are you? Calm down. I can't understand you when you're crying. Oh, you went to buy a flower for Miss Duffy, and now you're in an Uber car? And why are you crying? Because the guy speaks Spanish? And you don't know what propina grande is? That means big tip. You don't have the money? Well, who gave you the money to go? Okay, never mind all that. Look, where are you now? We're at 118 Chadwick. Siete diez ocho, please. Okay, look, you're here? All right. Pastor Joan, is she here? Would you do me a favor? You know him and how difficult he can be. Would you go out and get him for us, please? This is our pastor, Joan Collier.
Oh, she's using money from the treasury.
Who knew? Oh, Jack, thank you so much for bringing him in to us. Is this flower? Yeah, I do. I have it. I think so. I'll try not to. We're getting used to parenting skills going on. John's got any idea. Is this flower from Miss Stephanie? Well, would you like to take it?
Thank you. Thank you, Jack. That was very
Are you ready for your harp lesson? You are? Okay, well, look, this is probably the first time you've seen a harp. What do you think of it? And don't you think it's nice that Miss Duffy agreed to teach you? Do you think you need lessons to play a harp? Now, what would give you that idea? I don't think so, buddy. You have to take lessons. You have to start at the beginning. Now, how many strings are on this harp?
47.
Okay. All right.
Should we try playing a little something?
I think we should. What do you want to play?
Well, we're going to try this, Jack. Can you read music, Jack?
I know. I think I can see it.
Can you see what that is? Do you know what it is? Okay, let's try playing a little bit of it, and we'll see if anyone, if you or anyone in the audience can figure out what it is. Okay, so we're going to start on this string, and then this one, and then this one, and then that one, and two of those. Do you know what it is yet? All right, let's go a little farther. Start with this one, this one. That one, and one more, and then that one. Have you figured it out yet?
Yeah.
Has anyone else figured it out yet?
How about the girls? Girls, do you know what that song is?
No.
Are you American children? Does anybody know what that song is? The Rainbow Connection, terrific. This is the Rainbow Connection.
Okay. Well, why don't I play it for you, Jack, and then we can see about, you can add a little something in
there. Okay,
the
end.
That's
yeah. Okay.
Jack. Good job.
Mary, is Mary here? Oh, Mary. This is Joan's sister, Mary. She agreed to watch Jack for the rest of the program, so he is in your tender loving. Thank you, Mary. And thank you, Pastor Jones. Yes, you are.
I think that's next.
Yep.
I want to get out of the way.
Okay, we can't decide what's next, but I think we figured out what's next. So I was going to tell a funny story about how I was in, playing in American Girl store in New York City in the cafe, and they cheaped out on the harp, and they cheaped out on the bench, and the bench broke while I was playing. And I landed on my butt, on, you know, with the harp in my lap, and little girls asking, can you play Happy Birthday for my daughter? Her name is Shayla. But you know what, instead, I'm going to say, we lost Stephen Sondheim this year. Devastating. My two favorite Broadway shows are Sweeney Todd. But I'm not going to play something from Sweeney Todd. We're trying to be happy tonight. But I will play the probably most recorded Broadway song in history, Send in the Clouds.
Thank you.
want to thank so many people tonight. Choir, thanks the choir for coming out. You know, most of them are doing other things on Saturday night. So thank you, everybody in the choir. Muzz Skillings for playing the bass. And Steve Austin, where is he? Oh, there he is, for playing the organ. And in the back we have Ted Maker, who did the lighting. Jeffy Kist is working the machine there. And Chris Paolino is working the machine there. And Leanne Coleman, who is our usher, and Rick Coleman, our lady. And all the ladies and men who brought wonderful food at the reception, which is going to follow here in just a moment. So I think we thanked everybody. Now the Phantom of the Opera. You know, everybody wants to hear, you know, it's going to be an organ, that's your Phantom of the Opera. And with the harp, and it's just, it'll be fun. You may even hear thunder, who knows? Or feel it. Jesse, do you think they'll feel thunder?
I think they will.
Thank you. the warden, Rich Kearney, with the wardens here, and we're just so delighted that you came to join us on this beautiful, beautiful Saturday evening to listen to the fabulous music and enjoy the talent of George Wessner and Fran Duffy. We prepared a beautiful, beautiful reception for you. Again, where I come from, we tell you you're having cold cuts and carrots. But because he said he was playing a pastiche, I will tell you that we are having charcuterie and crudité right under these doors. And if you need to make a stop before you go into the reception, you'll find the restrooms also right through those doors. We're just delighted that you came, and we hope that you'll come back to join us. Now, I've done the charming part. I'm going to turn the other part over to Rich.
Thank you very much, Jana. So we, as Jana said, we are very, very happy that you could be here with us tonight. St. Mark's, in 3 years, it's going to be 2025, and St. Mark's will be celebrating its centennial. And so we'll be here for 7 years. And of course, this is a house of worship, but we also have tried over the years to be a community resource in lots of ways. We have a lot of programming here, including arts and cultural program. We have enormous gratitude to George and for bringing his friends and artists like Fran here and several others. And St. Mark's thrives in part on the basis of the support that it gets from its members and visitors. And we would invite you, if the spirit moves you, to contribute to the support of St. Mark's. We want to make this as easy as possible for you, so you'll see in the program, there's a QR code for you, those of you who do tech, and also on the, you'll find a similar thing on this card, which is in the pews, so there are several there that have been distributed. And our ushers also have baskets at both entrances, for more low-tech versions of that. So once again, thank you very much for being here. We have a little bit of music left, and it's going to involve some audience participation at the end, which we invite you to. And then please do join us for the post-concert reception in the parish hall. Thanks again for being here.
So let the Christmas season begin. The holiday season, let it begin here and now. Now you'll notice in the program you have a place to sing at the end. This is an excerpt from one of his letters. You know, this music you recognize, the Gloria, you know, the Hallelujah at the end. And everybody's invited to sing. So at some point when we get to that, angels we have heard on high, I'll just do this, and then you really do need to stand to sing that. And as my idol, my mentor, my friend, Virgil Fox used to say, I want you to sing like you never sang before. And when he would say that, people would do it. And it got to the point where you couldn't sing because it was too emotional. But tonight we're here. And we get to sing Gloria in Chelsea. It's a carol that every faith knows. So I tried to pick something that would be specific to a particular denomination. And we're mixing that, of course, with Frosty the Snowman. You guys know Frosty the Snowman? Did you ever hear Frosty the Snowman? Okay. These girls are not his little girls, and he brings them, they play here, and he practices in the choir. And he actually stunned me one Sunday. I walked up to him and I said, would you sing in the choir? He goes, okay. This is like the Jehovah's Witness who was invited in for breakfast. And the guy made a breakfast. He said to the Jehovah's Witness, so what do you want to talk about? He said, I don't know. I never got this far. Have you had a good time? Are you ready, my dear?
Sure.
All right.
You go first.
Do I start?
Yeah. It's all you.
Oh, it is? What a treat. All right. Thank you.
extremely outstanding Reverend Joan Connolly.
And remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.